Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. In this video I'm going to demonstrate the charging of capacitors in the dielectric field using the circuit that we've used before or we've seen before, powered by a 12 volt battery. This is that circuit here. I made a small modification here just in relation to this light bulb. I had this directly in line on the last schematic, but in actual fact it's through this switch. This light bulb comes, and it seems strange, but off the emitter, off the negative, and then down to the switch, and then pretty much straight back onto the same line. That's just the way it works, so it's a little weird. In red I've got here these an Avramenko plug there, and I forgot to draw in the diodes. That would be that in there, and this one would be that one there for the diode orientation. Okay, so that's basically an Avramenko plug. Or from what I think it's like a half wave bridge rectifier, but I'm just not sure which half. I'll have to check that up again later. But so we've got the Avramenko plug leading into two caps that are in series. They're 1400 volt DC 20 UF caps. That would be those two there. So come out of those caps, Avramenko plug, that's a yellow wire, follows through and connects to what I've labeled here on the board as earth one. Basically now I'll just show the different voltages that are obtained at different takeoff points and the differences between one and two earths. All right, so we connect this circuit up, negative. I usually turn this light on just so I can indicate sometimes the oscillations don't start every time, first time. Warning, bright light. Okay. All right, so it's clearly running. We'll turn that light off. Now, if we have a look on the capacitors, so they've already charged themselves up and they're not connected to anything. So that's just in the presence of the dielectric field that's in that coil. Okay, so 17 volts. We're set to 1000 volts on the DC scale. Alright, so that's with no actual connections. This yellow cable here that connects to the Avramenko plug, that could be considered as a small earth, any mass at all. When you're connecting those Avramenko plugs will change that capacity significantly. Now if we take a just this earth wire here out, that's on. So we take this earth wire and we connect that to the negative side of the capacitors. We can see that gives them a little more, not a lot though, for about 10 or 11 volts to be precise. So yeah, that's nothing fantastic. So that's just the one earth wire. If we take that off now that we've seen what that one earth wire does to the negative, we can place an earth into the system. I'll do that with a jumper lead so that we can have a look at the meter. Easier said than done. Okay, here we go. Apologize for the awesome camera work, people. Alright, so we have that connected. And now that's saying 39 volts. Really not much more potential. What if we connect the two earths, which are separate, are 60 meters apart? So one earth is now connected to the negative side of the capacitor. The other earth is connected to the negative of the battery. And that gives us 85 volts. Okay, so now if we take that off, and we take this earth off as well, and we see what happens when we connect the low voltage side of the coil. So we're taking the low voltage side of this coil, and we're going to connect that to the base of, that's going to go to the Avramenko plug, so to the yellow lead there, and then on to the Avramenko plug into the DC capacitor. So our current voltage before connecting that is 19 volts, and that's just obtained just through the dielectric field. So let's connect this now. Try and hold that so you can see the meter. I'm gonna do that. Okay, so that bumps it up significantly. Now we're looking at 170 plus, 180 volts. There, so that's significantly better. Now what happens if we connect in this first earth and we connect that to the negative terminal of the capacitors? Now it goes up again to 260 volts. So it's important to note here that like each different connection brings with it its own potential, its own capacity. It changes the frequency, changes resonance, changes absolutely every part of these circuits, and you end up with a completely different circuit. All right, so we're at 260 when we've got the low voltage side of the coil connected to the Avramenko plug and an earth to the capacitor, the negative side of the capacitor. Now we're sitting at 261, so let's see what happens when we connect this negative to the battery with the existing arrangement. And now she's climbing again. Yeah, from 280 something, I think it was, up to about 330 or so, and dropping. So circuit's still running. It's out of oscillation now though. Alright. One last thing to note. We have a voltage dropping off now, and it's possibly due to a change in frequency resonance. So if we take one of these ferrite cores and we place that into the coil, as we do that, we watch the voltage. Okay, so, oh damn, that bit me that time. Okay, you really have to watch what you're doing with this stuff. Okay, that's clearly over 1,000 volts there now. That didn't feel good either. Okay, so the dangers of filming while you're playing with electronics. So capacitors dropping down now with the ferrite core removed. If we place that ferrite core back in, and I'll watch the ferrite core, you guys watch the voltage. So we could possibly get it to a point where the ferrite core only goes in a certain distance, and we could probably maintain voltage then. But yeah, clearly it gets up to the dangerous side. I mean, those capacitors are 1400 volts, but we can't tell just how high over the 1000 that's going, so I'd rather not do that too often without a load across those, particularly when you see just how fast it changes. So yeah, it may seem like a basic circuit, and it may seem like it can't do much when it's only running on 12 volts, but oh, I just got zapped then and it didn't feel pretty. So, all right, thanks again. I'm going to end this here because it's way too hot to be outside right now. Okay, thanks again. Please like and subscribe.